Hello everyone, today we're going to see a very rich dessert which is nothing but the badam halwa. So badam halwa is prepared out of soaked almonds, sugar and ghee. This is definitely going to be a very rich dessert. Though you prepare with a large quantity, by the time you prepare it, it will be in a small quantity as well. Badam halwa is actually liked by all age groups, including from the small kids up to adults. From today's badam halwa recipe, I'm going to make another two dishes, nothing but the badam barfi as well as the badam uppittu. From today's episode, you'll be able to learn three dishes. So let's see how we can prepare this. For making badam halwa, for 1 big cup of badam paste, I'll be taking 1.5 cup of sugar and some milk required for grinding the badam and ghee approximately about the same measurement of 1 cup. And few strands of saffron and a pinch of cooking camphor. This is optional. I've taken 1 big cup of this cup of badam and I've soaked this in hot water so that we'll be able to peel off the skin nicely. So first I'm going to melt 1.5 cups of sugar. I'm also adding 2 cups of water approximately. Now I'm going to melt the sugar. So you can see now that the sugar is nicely melted. So I'm going to squeeze about 1/2 lemon. I'm squeezing this 1/2 lemon so that the dust from the sugar comes out and we'll be able to take it out easily. While the sugar syrup is getting boiled, what I've done is I've added the peeled badam by adding 1/2 cup of milk and I've ground this into a smooth paste. You need to allow the sugar syrup to boil nicely. The dirt will form as a big lather and it will come to the sides. You can see that. So I'm just taking out the dust. Just going to discard it. I've taken out the dust completely and we'll be adding the badam paste. Now I'm also adding a few strands of saffron. Let it be a lavish amount of saffron because that is only going to add the color of the badam halwa. So I can see a very nice color of the saffron. It is still in the watery consistency. What we need to do is we need to keep stirring it until it comes to a nice thick idli batter like consistency. And we need to also keep adding ghee so that it does not stick to the sides. The more the ghee you add, the flavor of the badam halwa actually enhances. You need to keep stirring this continuously, otherwise chances of getting it burnt is higher. So now you can see that it has come to a nice yellowish color. I have not added any kind of food color, but still it's come to a nice badam color. So as far as possible, scrape out from the sides. Otherwise, if you don't keep scraping the paste from the sides, it will tend to get thickened and burnt sometimes. So this is a small tip which I want to pass it on. While you are stirring it, you can add more ghee. This particular sweet requires a lot of ghee. 3/4 to 1 cup of melted ghee will be required for this particular dish. Now I am adding a small pinch of the cooking camphor. As I told you, this is optional, but this adds a very good flavor to the badam halwa. Now you can see it's become nice and thick. It's like a thick idli batter. So I'm just going to transfer this to a container here. After some time, it will become slightly thicker. So you can see the badam halwa is ready. In this existing badam halwa, I'm adding a few spoons of ghee. And we need to cook it for a few more minutes. I've been cooking the badam halwa for some more time. And you can see that it's come to a nice dough-like consistency. So once it comes to a nice dough-like consistency, we can switch off the gas and we can transfer this to the plate. And we can spread it like a barfi. After about 5 minutes, you can cut it. After some time, it will become slightly hard. So we have the badam halwa as well as the badam barfi. Now we are also going to do the badam uppittu or the obattu or the boli, whatever you call it as. So for that, I have taken 1 cup, approximately around 200 ml wheat flour. To this, I'm just going to add 1/2 teaspoon of sugar and around 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric powder.
I'll also be adding hot milk and we're going to make a dough. The consistency of this dough will be a little bit loose, not very hard like the chapati dough. So let's mix it. You can see the consistency of the dough, it's somewhat loose. You can add oil. I'm adding the ordinary refined oil only. So approximately around 4 teaspoons of oil is required and half a cup of milk. See, I've taken 1 cup of wheat flour. For that, half a cup of hot milk was required. So you can prepare this dough and keep it beforehand itself, because the more it soaks in the oil, it will be very nice. You can apply a little bit of oil on top and then leave it like that. And I'm using today a cling wrap. So I'm just going to leave it like this and then on top of it, cover it with the plate and leave it for about an hour. So it's been more than an hour. I'm just taking out. It's nice and soft and you'll be able to spread it nicely. So that will be the texture of the batter. I've also melted some ghee for making the uppittu. I have the dough ready and also the prepared badam halwa. Just for your reference, this is a small tip. If the prepared dough is in this quantity, the badam portion or the halwa portion will be slightly more than this. Then only you will get the appropriate amount of sweetness. And I am going to spread it on the butter paper. The same paper which I used for melting the butter. You can apply a little bit of ghee or oil for spreading. So you can keep a sizable amount of the badam halwa in the middle and slowly you close it. A lot of people prepare the dough with maida, but even with the whole wheat flour, it's come out very well. Now you can slowly spread it. So in the meantime, I'm going to heat up the pan as far as possible, make it as thin as possible. And the care should be taken so that the stuffing is more and the dough is less. And just make sure that the stuffing is spread evenly on all sides. Otherwise, what will happen is in one portion, the stuffing will be there, the other portion, it will not be there. So the prepared uppittu, I'm just inverting the butter sheet on the tawa. And slowly after a few minutes, we'll be able to take it out. Just going to cook this with a little bit of ghee. As far as possible, try to keep the flame somewhere between low to medium so that it gets cooked evenly. Now you can see that it's cooked nicely. You can take it out. We have all the three desserts ready. One is a badam halwa, one is a badam barfi, the other one is the badam uppittu or the uppittu. I've cut into triangle shape so that it will be easier for us to serve as well. And in today's recipe, I've used a little bit of cooking camphor as a flavoring agent. But in case if you don't like the flavor of the cooking camphor, you can always substitute that with the cardamom powder. So I hope you'll all try out this recipe. And if you like it, please share it with your friends and relatives. And please do not forget to click on the bell icon for further interesting notifications and the recipes. Have a very sweet day.